Hello friends, we have Babaji ji with us once again. Welcome Babaji ji.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you for coming. And Mr. Babaji ji is having his own YouTube channel and he has a large following of nearly 70,000 people. People can go and join his YouTube channel because he really speaks very beautifully about astrology, very simple to understand, and he has made so many videos. Can literally people can learn astrology from there.
Thank you very much.
And I'll give the give his YouTube link in my description box. Babaji ji, what are we going to do today?
I was thinking we could speak basically on introduction to the different dashas that we have in astrology, which I think is not very much discussed, in especially in YouTube. So in YouTube, the transits are always the focus. And there's nothing wrong with that. But when we are asking for like predictions especially, then we cannot use transits only. Transits are like the last. It's like the last.
Without a promise. Given by the dashas, the transits cannot do anything.
Yeah, because if you say that transits are all in all, then well, then there are 12 ascendants, so you have 12 transits in a day. So then everybody has to have the same thing. So there are only 12 people, 12 kinds of people. And it goes back to that same fancy theory in the West, you know, what's your sun sign, like that. So if we are of the same element, then yes, we get along well. Otherwise, we don't. So the thing is, dashas, like I used to hear from my childhood that as in Ramayana also it is said that when Ram and Ravan meets for the first time in the battlefield, then Lord Ram explains to Ravan, you know, what is Durdasha? Generally, we always hear this, you know, in villages or in towns, iski to durdasha chal rahi hai, ye, this, that. So, durdasha means basically, to put say, a dasha which, in which your intelligence is not working properly, you're making bad decisions. So, dasha means the literal translation in Sanskrit, that has many meanings, of course, but the literal translation is situation or position or your current status. So, how do you know what is your current status in every area of life? So, dashas are, so the thing is, one dasha will affect every area of your life. It will not happen that you are having the dasha of a particular house where a planet is sitting or it is lording and only that house is active. It will never happen. Because when the dasha gets activated, then it is said that the planet where that planet is sitting. So somebody is in Vimshottari dashas. We have different dashas. We will discuss about it later. But suppose in Vimshottari, somebody is running Jupiter Mahadasha. So that person's Jupiter is in Cancer, you know, in exaltation somewhere in some house. So then they say we should put that as the ascendant and check from there how the placements are. So then what happens? Then the whole horoscope changes. every planet's lordship and placement changes. Everything changes actually. So therefore, we should never think that. Sometimes people think that, oh, my seventh lord is activated now. I will get married. Maybe. And then, but that does not mean that the other houses are not getting activated. Yes, and the whole horoscope is getting, actually the horoscope is always active. It is never that the dasha changes and the horoscope becomes active. Horoscope is always active, but the dasha will change your focus basically. So now when this particular house is activated, then you know that, okay, now for these many number of years, this is going to be my prime focus in life. Everything else is secondary. Because people say, what happens when dashas change? Well, the simple answer is your priorities change. So when suppose somebody's seventh house is active, so maybe the person was always married from last 20 years. And that does not mean that he will again get married. But it means that now his priority will shift to marriage, you know.
To married life.
Yes, yes. So, yeah, and of course, now if he or she is divorced, then maybe they can get married again. That's a separate issue. But the thing is, our priorities change. So everybody has a priority list. And that priorities are dependent on the horoscope, not on the dashas. So basically, it means if somebody has a very strong fifth house or like third house, I have seen. So their eternal priority is, you know, I should be into some creativity work, creativity sector, or, you know, writing, singing, dancing, these kind of things. So that the dasha cannot decide. The dasha will tell you among that where you are focusing. That is what is the job of the dasha. But now sometimes there are contradictory things. For example, I have seen especially the 5th house and 10th house. Although they are very good houses, but somehow they are not well placed from each other.
Yeah, they have a 6-8 relationship.
Yes, yes.
Whenever we do consultations, the first thing that we see is the 10th lord, if in 5th lord. Then we have observed in many, many charts that they don't have a steady profession or focused on one profession only. They have that job again and again, shifting, not satisfied.
Bang on, you're bang on. And that's so funny, you know. It's like that is a trine, but even I've seen with the 9th house also. You know, if the 10th lord is in 9, the person is always shifting careers. Why? Because it's 12 from the 10th, right?
10th house.
Yeah. Right. So then there becomes a contradiction between the horoscope and the dasha. So suppose somebody has, you know, major planets like Sun, Moon, Lagna Lord, Atma Karak in the 5th. And then the person wants to be very creative, lifelong, irrespective of the dashas. But then you get this dasha of the 10th Lord, which has started. And then, you know, you somehow prioritize your work and your career, your money, your status, name, fame, you know, above your creativity and all this stuff. You know. So then it is like you are somebody, but you are forced to do something else. Yeah, that is what the dashas do. Yeah, so yes, as we know, in Vedic astrology, there are many different dasha systems. So one of the most prominent and primary or the standard is Vimshottari dashas, as we all know. So Vimshottari is a calculation for 120 years, which is very complicated, which I will not go here. But if you go to any website, you know, especially astrosage.com, you can get your report of dashas, which dasha you are running. So in that, if you see, the structure is very well defined for Vimshottari. So there is a default structure. So for example, the default Vimshottari starts from Ketu. So first is Ketu, then Ketu is for 7 years, you know. Then we have Venus Mahadasha. Venus is the longest, it is 20 years. And then we have Sun, which is very short, it's for 6 years only. So then we have Moon, 10 years, you know. Then we have for the other planets also like this. And Saturn is, of course, 19 years, which shows suffering. And Venus is 20 years, you know. So one of my astrology teachers, he used to say, on a spiritual angle, he used to explain why Venus Mahadasha is just a bit more than Saturn Mahadasha. He said that if it would be the reverse, no? 19.9 and Saturn 20, just a bit more. The entire world would have been totally different now than the way it appears. But that 1 year, you know, if you calculate, that one year is like one extra year, so 1/19. That's not a very huge percentage, you know, that's very less. Venus has that percentage more time than Saturn. So what does this mean? He used to say that the materialistic world, which is also known as Maya Nagari.
Exactly.
Okay, so as Krishna says in the Gita, that Dukhalaya Mashashvatam, this material world is a place of misery. Yeah. But how this material world has been designed is that the amount of pleasure you get is always slightly more. just that 1 year difference, you know, if you calculate percentage, it's just bit more than suffering. So that is why what happens, even if you suffer, you know, somewhere or the other you keep getting pleasure, because of which you feel that this world is a very nice place, basically. Why to, you know, do spiritual practices and elevate your consciousness? That is not required, you know. This is such a nice place. Yeah, life is bad sometimes. It is also good.
But it will get better someday.
Exactly. That is like the hook, you know. And imagine if Saturn Mahadasa was, you know, like 5 years or 10 years. Then I mean, it would be like a perfect situation, you know. But that's the fun, you know. It's like almost cut to cut. So then we Moon 10 years, as I said, then we have Mars 7 years. Mars and Ketu have the same time. And then we have Rahu, which for freaking 18 years. You know, and then we have Jupiter. Jupiter is a bit short than Rahu again. And then we have Saturn. Jupiter goes for 16 years, Saturn 19, and Mercury is the last. It is 17 years. So if you sum up these numbers, you will get around 120. And then we have, so Vimshottari Dasha has three parts, as you know. The one is the Mahadasha, the other is the Antara Dasha, other is Pratyantar. And there are also lower levels below,
Sukshma and all that. Yeah, right.
But in my practical experience, I don't use after level 3 because of two reasons. First reason is 99% of the birth times are not accurate, which means they are different by certain minutes, which the person who is telling you will never agree, because he or she will say, no, birth time is 100% correct. My grandfather wrote, my mother wrote, my father wrote, that nurse wrote. But then when we verify, we always see it is not 100% accurate. And the other reason is, if you change the Ayanamsha and the calculations, then sometimes literally the Pratyantara Dasha shift by 1 month, I've seen.
Yes, it does.
Yes, so then it is very difficult to go below. And especially below. If it is of a planet like, you know, Ketu, Sun, Mars, then it's barely some days. Like Sun, Mars, Ketu, Sun, Ketu, Mars. Yeah,
correct.
Because their Mahadashas are very small. So now, how do you know what is the meaning of Mahadasha and Antaradasha and Pratyantara? And there's this, one of my seniors used to give a beautiful example to illustrate this. He used to say that, suppose you are going to buy a car. Then Mahadasha means which company are you going to buy? From which company? Are you going to buy from Maruti or Toyota, or you are going to buy Mercedes, or you are going to buy Rolls Royce? Which one?
Which one? Okay.
Yes, that is like the company name. And then Antardasha is like the model number of the car. Okay, Mahadasha is great, fantastic. So what is the Antardasha telling? Okay, maybe you are going to purchase, you know, from Maruti maybe. Then which model, you know, Maruti Zen or, you know, Maruti Alto or
whatever. Yeah.
Yes. And then the Pratyantara Dasha is like the accessories which you have inside the car. So suppose your Mahadasha is great, your Antardasha is great. So then maybe you go and buy a Mercedes, maybe, you know, S-Class or anything like that. But suppose your Pratyantara is not very good for that area of life, huh? For that area, then maybe you'll be like, okay, I got this S-Class, but no more music system, no more special tires, I'm done.
Okay, correct.
So that is it, no more expenses. So that is how you can understand. So the Mahadasha planet will give you the status, the level at which you will play, basically. And whatever antardashas you get in between, the antardashas can either add to it or try to reduce it, but cannot do things which the Mahadasha Lord doesn't agree. So for example, somebody suppose, let's take the example of marriage. So for somebody, if the Mahadasha Lord is denying marriage somehow, then it does not matter which antardasha you are running. Even if you run planets of dasas of planets like Jupiter or Venus, situated in the second or seventh or 11th house, you will not get married. Why? Because the Mahadasha Lord has now told that my status is that I will follow celibacy. That's all. So now what happens? Suppose your Mahadasha Lord is saying you will not get married, and these antardashas are keep coming for marriage. So then it's like saying you get too many proposals to get married, but somehow at the end the marriage doesn't happen. So and they also say Mahadasha is like the Atma, it is like the soul, and antardasha is like the mind, and Pratyantar is like the body.